Focus on the glitter of a bustling young movie town at the height of its golden age. The Hollywood Tower Hotel was a star in its own right, a beacon for the show business elite. Now, something is about to happen that will change all that. For a different kind of introduction. This, as you may recognize, is a maintenance service elevator, still in operation, waiting for you. We invite you, if you dare, to step aboard, because in tonight's episode, you are the star, and this elevator travels directly to the Twilight Zone.
Everyone, please continue down the
again, and this time it's opening for you.
Pretty much a lot of pull around the area. He's been here for quite a long time. And he may be able to drive through in between sets. I'll let you know a little later on the tour. By the way, folks, feel free to film as much video and camera as you like. Or shoot. Because on our backstage tour, you never know who or what you might see. Well, off to your immediate right is our prop warehouse. And just beyond that is our motor pool, one of our outdoor storage facilities. The bullet-ridden sedans you see were used in the film Dick Tracy, starring Warren Beatty, Al Pacino, and Madonna. Now, here's your first photo opportunity. If you look high in the sky off to your right, is the symbol of Disney MGM Studios, the award-winning Earful Tower. Now, that tower stands a lucky 13 stories tall and is topped off by a set of Mickey Mouse ears. Each of those ears weighs over 5,000 pounds. Now, for all you trivia buffs, that's a hat size of 342 3/8. And we know this because during the holiday season, we top that tower off with a red stocking cap. A little bit closer to the ground, in airports around the country knew this Gulfstream one as the 234 Mickey Mouse. But here at the studios, we simply refer to it as the Mouse. Walt bought the plane in 1964 and used it to fly secret scouting missions over Central Florida in search for the perfect location of Walt Disney World. The two silver space pods there that we're passing were used in the Disney film Flight of the Navigator. And as we navigate this corner, the bungalow is off to the left. Oh. We're used in production, where production crews uses their headquarters while filming at the studios. In recent weeks, we've had such things as the ABC sitcom Family Matters film their season finale. Ooh. Off to the right is a small branch of our greenery department. Here we store plants, trees, and shrubs until they're ready to be used on set. Now, greenery is often used to hide what the camera isn't supposed to see. That's why we grow them in portable boxes so they easily can be transported from set to set. Now, if we use them in our sound stages, we must fireproof each leaf, branch, and twig. And that is because the intensity of the lights in the side of sound stages. At the end of our greenery department is sculpted plants we call topiaries. Now, they're made of ficus leaves and sphagnum moss and take anywhere from 3 months to 10 years to develop, depending on size and shape. We have a cast of over 180 topiaries in our throughout our resort. Well, it looks like Greg's taking us into a section of the tour we call creative costuming. In costuming, it all starts out with the up to 180 artists design and manufacture costumes for our motion picture television entertainment needs here at the Walt Disney World. In some of the display cases, you will be able to see actual costumes worn by the actors and actresses in their represented production. Well, folks, it takes a lot more than a pretty costume to put on a great show. There's also technical sides to our studio, and that's where our lighting, audio, and camera departments come in. And you'll be able to see that off to your left. This is where we put together sophisticated equipment packages used by production crews on our sound stages and backlot. We also provide crews for such things as rock concerts, location shoots, and any other needs around the country. 10 years. Until it was used and modified for video production, our plane was recently hijacked on Sound Stage 3 in the film Passenger 57, starring Wesley Snipes. Now, off to your left is our scenic shot, where carpenters put together and maintain sets used on our backlots and sound stages. Currently, they're working on The Spirit of Pocahontas, which makes its theater debut June 23rd in our backlot theater. Well, our carpenters got a little crazy one today, and they filmed right here. That solar van you see was one of three identical props used in the film. Underneath the green canopy, you'll see our underwater special effects tank. Here, created for Terry Hulk Hogan in Thunder in Paradise, the bottom of that pool is actually carved out to look like the ocean floor. Well, it looks like we're going deeper into our back lot, into a street we call residential. Now, a lot of people say, Brian, I would love to come and live at Walt Disney World, but folks, before you pack your bags, take a look at the first house coming up on your right side. The art says it all, open house. There are no insides or backs to any of these homes on the street. When Jim Varney was filming Ernest Saves Christmas, he used house number 242 for the exterior shot of Vern's house. Now, because different scripts call for different neighborhoods, we have 8 different styles of American architectural represented. On your left side, that pink Mercedes-Benz you see there was driven by Dolly Parton in Straight Talk. Okay, now we come to Sophia. The exteriors of that house were filmed here, and the actual show was filmed in California. Now, if she wanted to answer the door, that would be quite a walk. The next home here is Alice's home in the Disney Channel's Adventures in Wonderland. And her right across the street on your right side is the Touchstone Television hit sitcom Empty Nest, starring Richard Mulligan, Dinah Manoff, and my personal favorite, our 30-foot dog. And that was used in The Rocketeer. That's the Bulldog Cafe. Where the Flyers meet to eat. The small TV airplane you see there. In the film, Howard Hughes gave that to The Rocketeer. In reality, it's nothing more than a full-size prop that never quite got off the ground. Well, if you look straight ahead, and it's actually modeled after an SR, that boat is actually modeled after an SR-71 Blackbird spy plane, and it's been flapped at speeds of over 70 miles an hour. That 1920 black Chrysler car with the green spokes was used in The Untouchables, starring Sean Connery and Kevin Costner. That big C-123 cargo plane was used in a film called Operation Dumbo Drop, starring Danny Glover, Ray Liotta, and Dougie Doug. That movie is set to release sometime this summer. Now, the military-looking vehicles you see along with this huge tank were used by director Steven Spielberg in the film Indiana Jones and the Last Crusade. If you notice the rubber treads on the tank, and if you notice the treads, they're actually made of rubber. That was for the safety of the stuntmen and actors. The 3 blue Plymouths were used in the film Who Framed Roger Rabbit. Each time Detective Eddie Valant drove his girlfriend's Dolores car into Toontown and was hit, blown up, then we would have to use another one. There was a total of 7 in the production. The trolley car you see there is actually a bus modified to look like a trolley car. If you notice, the fiberglass steel wheel, those steel wheels are actually fiberglass plates fitted over the tires of the bus. As we pass our executive yacht club, the push carts and battered bobsled was used in the 1993 film Cool Runnings, starring Dougie Doug and John Candy. The 2 futuristic cars, the blue and white ones, were used in the film Blade Runner, starring Harrison Ford. The small red car was used in Hardcastle and McCormick. Now, if you look across the canal, there's a backstage view of our residential street. If you notice, some of the architectural designs, such as the shingles, only come to where the camera can see. Now, that's an old Hollywood production trick we call saving money. And saving money we need to do, because it looks like Greg has gotten us in some clearance into here. They must be, yeah, it's about lunchtime for these guys, so we're going to be pulling in. We do ask that you remain seated, because we will be pulling out a bumpy bridge. Please grab a hold of items like your cameras and purses, and maybe your favorite small children. As we enter the canyon, I'd like to tell you a little bit about it. It was modeled after an actual canyon in Southern California, and it took our production crew nearly 6 months to develop. Now, that's a long time for one set, but if you consider the length of time it takes Mother Nature to put the whole thing together, it's really not that bad. We will be stopping in the canyon so that you guys all can take pictures and take a closer look at it. And I can tell you a little bit more about it. Well, you can't see it from here, but directly above your head is the platform where production crews mount their camera so they can shoot down into the canyon. Now, that tanker truck you see there was actually stored in our boneyard. However, the production crew needed it for the set, so we couldn't drive it across the ravine. So we had to hoist it up and over the canyon wall and back down into the canyon with a crane. The water dripping you see there they were probably testing a rain effect. Production crews often like those drugs. There must be someone left. This is a rain effect.
CGI, the two-dimensional camera, it actually appears to be raining throughout the entire mandate. If you notice closely. Scene 1 picture. It looks like we're going to be in the scene, ladies and gentlemen. Hang on. Guys, we're still in the canyon.
These stars, But I reckon you ought to do what you think is best. Now that we're in the clear, this is the perfect time for me to start collecting up all your valuables. Take it.
One by one, the pool has vanished. And somewhere in the ship, a terrifying creature waits to play.
I don't like the sound of that.
Warning, remain in your vehicle. The area you are entering is extremely dangerous. Proceed with caution.
Well, you got your good days, and you've got your bad days. This is definitely a...
Yeah. Studios still screening the films that made them.
Disney Pictures presents a new cinema. unsinkable. In our action-packed adventure, all hands on deck. Are you ready, Captain? Then get those binoculars up because here we go. You're on patrol in the deepest, darkest region of our special effects water tank when off in the distance you spot a battleship. That's right, it's over this way, Captain. You run a torpedo to the battle section. Fire one, Captain. Nice shot. Unfortunately, it was one of ours. Now look what you've done. Enemy planes coming in. Turn close. Down, Captain, down.
You're on top of this giant bee, you're flying through the backyard. It's the scariest ride of your life. When I say action, I want you to wave your arms, kick your feet, act like you're really scared. Cameras ready.
Ready.
And action. Wave those arms, guys. Kick those feet. If you look at the bee, you see it remain stationary on the floor. Take a look at those monitors. You'll see how our computer-assisted camera makes it appear that the bee's flying.
Thanks. Two theaters on our tour, so before we do, please take your time and look around at all the displays and exhibits while I tell you just a little bit about our showcase gallery. Pocahontas. Now, although the characters in Pocahontas are based on real-life figures, our version is more of a love story than a historical drama. Goon will be doing her singing. The music will be provided by Academy Award-winning composer Alan Menken, who previously won Oscars for his work on the Little Mermaid production of this film. Altogether, it took over 775 Disney artists, animators, and technicians almost 4 years and more than 1 million drawings to complete Pocahontas. Nearly 20 minutes, the film's total animation was completed right here in our These are coveted by museums, galleries, and private collectors throughout the world. The artwork in this collection, you can see several of the Oscars that have been awarded to the Walt Disney Studios. Following the award-winning tradition of The Little Mermaid, Beauty and the Beast, and Aladdin, The Lion King just won two more Oscars, one for Best Original Score, and the other for Best Original Song. That was Can You Feel the Love Tonight, bringing the total number of Academy Awards for display in our showcase gallery. You've all come at a great time. Our animators have recently begun work on the first animated feature that's going to be entirely made at our Florida studio. It's going to be called The Legend of Mulan. Our staff has nearly tripled in size since the doors first opened at the Disney MGM Studios on May 1st, 1989. We still have a few minutes before we head into the first theater, folks, so please take your time and look around. If you have any questions?
Calm yourself, Cotsworth, and keep it simple. here?
Oh, dear.
No need to worry.
We'll keep it simple.
If we're going to do, then let's do it.
But of course, we must make them feel welcome. Invite you to relax, pull up a chair, as the dining room proudly presents your dinner.
Tracy.
Just in 1 second.
That's right.
Yeah.
Hey, Chris, I got to talk to Rebecca about this next thing.
All of these stunts are real, as are the risks.
Joe, have a good time?
Oh, excellent.
Good. Any volunteer? Joe, some things an extra will do something really great and get a bigger part in the film.
Thank you.
gentlemen, boys and girls, Disney MGM Studios is proud to present Sorcery in the Sky. Light. Camera. Action.
To marry animation to classical music and a beat.